So we have discussed two types of bases. In the earlier class, we have discussed two types of bases, one along the tangent and the other perpendicular to the planes. In rectangular coordinates, the two bases, these two bases along the tangent and perpendicular to the planes are the same. But in general, or in any oblique coordinate system, or in general, we cannot say that in, as for example, in rectangular coordinates, the unit vectors along the increasing or along the tangents to the axis and perpendicular to the planes, so this is I, so along the x-axis, the base, the unit vector or unit vectors along the x-axis, which is noted as I, which is this along the tangent, along the increasing direction of the x-axis, as well as perpendicular to the planes formed by y and z. Similarly, j and k. But in general, we have found that there are two types of bases, one along the tangent and other perpendicular to the planes. In three-dimensional inclined planes, the set of basis vectors which we have discussed along the tangents is we have denoted as E1, E2, and E3, and those which are perpendicular to the planes as E1, E2, E3. These we have called as covariant, these as contravariant. Any vector can be expanded either in terms of covariant or in terms of contravariant. As for example, a vector A, we can expand it in terms of say a covariant. This is written as A1, E1. Remember that these are opposites. If this is in terms subscript, this is superscript. And this is A2, A2, A3, A3. So A1, A2, A3 are called the contravariant components. A1, A2, A3 are called the contravariant components of vector A. These are contravariant components. We can also write this same vector in terms of contravariant basis, where the components will then be covariant. So this will be written as A1, E1, A2, E2, plus A2, E3. But these are E1, E2, E3 are along the tangents, and these are along the perpendiculars to the planes. So E1 will be actually perpendicular to the planes formed by E2, E3. So this can be written as A, and 2e cross e3 is perpendicular to e2 e3 planes, which is along e1, and so a times e1, and this is, so it is a2 will then be written as e3 cross e1 not a, and this whole thing, yes, a3 can be written as this 1 2 e1 you see that these two bases e1, e2, e3 covariant bases and this contravariant bases are reciprocal to each other. So we will reciprocal means they are perpendicular to each other. The volumes formed by this and the volumes formed by this, the product of their volumes will be 1. So their volumes are reciprocal. The volumes formed by these bases and the volumes formed by these bases are reciprocal volumes. We will see that for a vector to be reciprocal, for a set of vectors, suppose we have two sets of vectors, and for them to be reciprocal, suppose we have a set of vectors, a set of vectors A, B, C, then this is condition for reciprocal, for vectors to be reciprocal, these are conditions. For a set of vectors A, B, C and A dash, B dash, C dash to be reciprocal, A dot A dash is equal to B dot B dash is equal to C dot C dash is equal to 1, and A dot A dash B is equal to A dash C equal to B dash A is equal to C dash A is equal to C dash B is 0. These are conditions set of vectors A, B, C and A dash, B dash, C dash are reciprocal if and only if. A dash is equal to B means which is perpendicular to the plane B and C, and obviously that will be along A divided by the volume. Volume means A dot B cross C. So B dash. So this will be perpendicular to B cross. So this will be C cross A, and divided by volume of the type of vectors ABC. So there is C equal to A cross B divided by its volume B cross. That is the volumes formed by A dash, B dash, C dash of the reciprocal vectors is inverse to the volume formed by the vectors A, B, C. The volumes formed by this will be inverse to the volume formed by this. So this is the condition. So we'll see that the volumes formed by the primed one, A dash, B dash, C dash. And we will see that the volumes formed by this is inverse of the volumes formed by this set. Now, A prime, which we have just done, was B cross C divided by A dot B cross C. This is B cross, and B cross was C cross A. Cross of C prime C dash, and C dash was A now first we'll solve numerator part, because numerator is common. So now first solve these two. Solve C cross A and A cross B. Left C cross A will be a vector. Let this denote it as D. Let C cross A is denoted by another vector D. So this will be D cross A cross D cross A cross B. This is a cross product of three vectors. So this will be We know that if the vectors A cross B cross C is written as B, so we will write and we'll see that this is equal to A plus or minus. This follows this A cross B cross C. If you have, you all don't know. The substitute the values of D, D is C cross A. So it will be A C cross A. Minus B and D is C cross A dot. This can also be written as simply let it be as it is B dot. This can, this side we can write as C dot A cross A. But A cross A will give you 0. So this is A. B dot C cross A is the volume. Let it be B dot. Substitute this value here. So this is B dot C cross A, which is the volume. This is also the volume. So one of the volume term will cancel out from the above. And we are left with So this is this quantity. Now solve the numerator part. It will be B cross C times this, which is this. So that's it. We have solved the comp. We have obtained these values. Shoot here. So this will be B cross C times A dot. B cross B dot C cross A. Yes. B dot C cross. Here dot plus, so it was here dot, 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 dot. So here to start. This is A dot B cross C. This thing. And this is again B dot C cross A. A dot B cross C means the volume of formed by ABC. This is also V dot C cross is also volume. So it is actually volume square. And the denominator we have volume cube. So we have found that the volume V dash is equal to V square by V cube, that is 1 by, that is the volumes formed by the vectors A dash, B dash, C dash, and the volume formed by A, B, C are reciprocal. So these are the, this means these two vectors are reciprocal. So a set of unit vectors, base vectors, you will see that they are also reciprocals. Set of unit base vectors, that is E1, E2, E3 and E1, E2. Are also reciprocal. So the volumes formed by E1, E2, E3. Volume formed by E1, E2 will be E1 times E2 cross. And obviously this volume will be 1 because these are unit vectors. And E2 cross E3, which is will be a vector which is perpendicular to the plane formed by E2, E3, and that vector will be along perpendicular. So this will be perpendicular to unit vectors will be this. This means covariant and contravariant. They give you. Now, if we write like this, say E2 dot E2 cross, obviously this will be 0 because E2 cross E3 is a vector perpendicular to the plane, and this will be so they will be 0. They do not form volume. Their volume is 0. So the volume is 0. It means E2 E1 is 0. In general, we can write that. So in general, we can write that EI is equal to 1, or suppose let it as k will be 1 only when I is equal to k, will be 0 when I is not equal to k, where I and k are indices. Now we start relation between covariant and contravariant components. Any vector can be represented either in terms of covariant basis or contravariant basis. So we can write any vector, an arbitrary vector A. Let us write it in terms of covariant basis with contravariant components. Components of A, contravariant components of A with covariant basis. These are contravariant components of A and these are covariant basis, or simply you can write this AK. Summation is not required because we know that the using Einstein's summation convention we can write without using the sign of summation here. Because it's stated in this is summation is implied here. Now take the scalar part of this suppose let us call this as equation number 1. Take the scalar part of this with equation number with AI. With scalar part of AI. This is B. AK. Now this A vector A dot product with the base vector covariant is EI. This is going to give you EI covariant split to the vector. Because we will write simply now all these. Now this K I let us write this as E K E I as G K I. So the dot product of E K E I, this is G K I or as A I. G I K or K I. So this covariant component of the vector A is related to contravariant component by this. This is called metric. This is a tensor. It's called metric. Here we have denoted the vector A in terms of covariant. The same vector can also be represented in terms of contravariant. Let us now represent A in terms of contravariant basis. So the components here is A2. Or this is AK. Now multiply it by EI. Take the dot product of this. So this will give you AK, EK dot. EI. So this will give you AI with G AI. Okay. Here you can remove this also. You can write it. If you have to write, then you have to write both sides. Here also you can write. So these are the called metric here. This contravariant component of the vector A is related to its covariant part by this GKI, and this GKI is called metric. So similarly, we can have you can multiply here. You take this equation again. This is A is equal to AK. Okay. On multiply here by EI. Take the mark from dot product of here by EI. This is G K I A K. So all these G R K is equal to G K I. Because it is E I dot E K or E K dot E I, same. Similarly, we can write as G I K is equal to G K I. G I K is equal to G K I. These are called metric, which transforms from covariant to contravariant and contravariant to covariant. Now we have seen that a contravariant component can be written as in terms of contravariant component can be written in terms of covariant vector, as we have seen just contravariant component in terms of covariant components. Here, A I is a contravariant component. This has to be expressed in terms of covariant. So that the covariant component is L. So this can be written as A G I L. This contravariant A I is connected to covariant A L by this metric, and this is actually AI GIL is actually summation over GIL by capital G times, where GIL or GIL is this quantity, and GIL is GIL by, but what is capital G? Actually capital G is the parametric, is the determinant of this G11, G12, G13, G21, G22, G23, G31, G32, G. Determinant. And this GIL is the cofactor. Suppose I is 1 and L is 1. So it is A1, A1. So it will be G11. So it will G11. This is the cofactor of G11. The cofactor of G11 will be this quantity. So the cofactor, suppose we want to write G11. So G11 will be the cofactor of G11. So the cofactor GIL is the cofactor of this GIL. So if you want to write G11, G11 means the cofactor. So the cofactor of G11 means you remove this, this will be the cofactor of G11. So similarly, the cofactor of G12 will be this quantity. So we write G11, the cofactor of this will be equal to G22, G23, G32, G33. This is summation over L. Actually, GIL, what was GIL? GIL was the dot product of EI and EL. EI and EL. This was the GIL. And now EIL, EL. Now we know that E1, E2, E3. E1, E2, E3. They are reciprocal. This basis, and this basis, they are reciprocal. Yes. It means EI, which is if I, suppose we have taken IJK and LMN. So it will be EJ cross EK. Divided by its volume, and this is EM cross EM. Instead of here, we have taken IJK. So it is JK. It is expressed in terms of reciprocal basis. So it is 1 by V square. This is EJ, so it is EJ cross EK. Times this is dot product here times EM cross EM. This we can write as V square EJ cross. Same result. So it is cross product of two vectors. It is again EK EJ cross EM minus EJ EK. It is written as 1 by b square ek dot en ej j dot en minus ej dot en and ek dot en ek dot. This is 1 by v square. This is g k n g j m minus g k m g j n. And this is nothing but this is 1 by v square. G J M G J M G K M G K M G J M J G K M G J M G K M minus G K M G J M. So the comparing this we get that from this we get that G is nothing but V square. Or the volume is plus minus under root g. So if you take g, this we take only positive values, means if you take v as under root g, if you take v as under root g. That is the v is the volume formed by the parapet formed by volume formed by these three and these. Similarly, v dash will be equal to under root g, which will be formed by the base vectors e1, e2. So g and g dash is equal to 1. So it is so we have found that g I k is equal to g I k. Is equal to g I k is equal to 1 when I is equal to k and 0 when I is not equal to k. This e I dot e k, this is also e dot I, e I dot e k. And these are as a result we can write vector say covariant component can be expressed in terms of contravariant components or a2 can be a2 to a3 is equal to g3 3 or a1 as g1 1 is as g 2 2 a 2 a 3 as g 3 3 and obviously and g
1 is equal to 1 by g 1
similarly
g 2 is equal to 1 by g 2 g 3 is equal to 1 by g 3.
Okay, all these about covariant and contravariant components
and their relationship.
And what about relationship between covariant and contravariant components? G mu mu is called the metric. In the next class we will apply this for certain cases.